हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ आई एम कांति सर एंड हार्टली वेलकम्स यू इन आवर ऑनलाइन मैथ्स क्लास. इन टुडेज माय फर्स्ट लेक्चर एंड योर्स आल्सो फर्स्ट लेक्चर फॉर न्यू चैप्टर. एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर न्यू चैप्टर नंबर 14. इट इज एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल्स. नाउ इन अर्लियर स्टैंडर्ड्स यू फाउंड मेनी टाइम्स एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल्स. सो ऑलमोस्ट फॉर्मूला एंड एप्लीकेशंस आर रिपीटिंग ओनली, बट वन थिंग विल बी न्यू एंड दैट विल बी हेरॉन्स फॉर्मूला. यू नो फॉर्मूला ऑफ एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल इज हाफ इंटू बेस इंटू कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग अल्टीट्यूड. सो दैट यू नो. एंड यू फाउंड एरिया ऑल्सो इन अर्लियर स्टैंडर्ड्स. नाउ if altitude is not given but instead all sides of triangles are given, then how to find area of that triangle? That is new for you, and this is possible by Heron's formula. So in this chapter particularly we will study and we will practice Heron's formula here, but many times you have to apply this formula also. So before starting that Heron's formula, let's discuss first of all remaining formula also. Okay, so that this is the general formula applicable for any type of triangles, and you know type of triangles also. You know equilateral triangle and isosceles triangle also. Equilateral triangle means all sides of triangle are equal, and isosceles triangle means any two sides of triangles equal. Now this is the basic one, but if you modify this same formula for particular triangle, particular type of triangle, then it may be new. Okay, it is up to you how to interpret. Okay, so now let's see area of right angle triangle. You know in right angle triangles angle is of 90 degree. So if it is ABC and right angle at B, then obviously if I say base here, then altitude is that. So if any one side is base, then obviously other side becomes altitude. For that altitude means what? Altitude means a line segment joining vertex and opposite side vertically. Vertically means again what? Altitude means that. So making 90 degree at base. Making 90 degree at base. Okay, so start from vertex and meet to opposite side at right angle at 90 degree. So obviously it is altitude here. So I can write here area of right angle triangle is equal to what? So half into product of sides containing right angle or forming right angle. So basically it is from this one only. Okay, so product of sides containing right angle. So those two sides which forming or containing right angle. This is also side, but mostly we term it as a hypotenuse, but it can be told side also. So you have to clarify here ki which two sides out of three. Okay, so altitude into base only, but both are sides here. Otherwise, what happens? Suppose it is not of right angle triangle, then altitude not become side here. Here altitude will be let AD. Okay, but here altitude itself is a side. Okay, so this is base here, h is altitude. So here you can say base into altitude into half. Now let's see for second one, area of equilateral triangle. Area of equilateral triangles is equal to root 3 by 4 into side square. Which side? Any side, because all sides are equal there. We will derive that formula also. Okay. So first of all, see only formula, because side, all sides are equal, but where from this formula came? Okay, just wait. After that we will derive it. Number 3, area of isosceles triangle. Equal to b by 4, 4a square minus b square. What is b and a again? So here you can write symbol also, l or a or whatever you want. Okay. Here a and b means two equal sides are here labeled as a, and this is b. Okay, so for isosceles triangle it is this. Okay, so equilateral triangle we cover, isosceles triangle also, and right angle triangles. Otherwise for remaining any type of or general triangle, you can apply this one if base and altitudes are given. Now sometimes you may confuse whenever you come across obtuse triangle. Okay, so let's see here. Suppose I am given obtuse triangle, then altitude will be what? Suppose I want to take base this one. Okay, so actually altitude means, I told you, the perpendicular distance of base from vertex. Which vertex? That which is not included by that side. So perpendicular distance of vertex to base. So obviously this will be altitude. Okay, we can see here half into b into h also. Mostly you remember this formula that way. So it becomes h. Okay. So it is not necessary that altitude will be always inside of triangle, maybe outside of triangle also. Okay, so keep in mind that. So these are formula of triangles for specific types of triangle, and this is general. Okay, so I hope you understood. And we will derive both of this one also. Now you can take screenshot here, so that whenever it is necessary you can use. Okay, I just exit the screen as it is for half minute only. Okay, I writing that old formula again here. So A for area here, half into base into altitude by symbol. This is general one. Now for right triangle. So this was one. Now we're talking about next one for right triangle. Area will be half into A into B, means any one side and any other side, but not hypotenuse, remember it. Number three, equilateral triangle. So let's write it's root 3 by 4 A square. A means measure of any side. In general, on most of we say side, side means you understand measurement of that side. For isosceles triangle, it is B by 4, 4 A square minus B square. Okay, now let's derive this one. Suppose any triangle is here, which is equilateral, means all three sides are equal, let they are AAA. Now, if you draw here median, anyone, actually in a triangle, three medians, three altitude may be there, because from each vertex you can draw one. Okay, so let's draw any one altitude. So I drawing here altitude. So that altitude becomes median also here. Why? Because if you draw altitude from common vertex of two equal sides. Again, if you draw altitude from common vertex of two equal sides, then it will become median also. So it is median as well as altitude. Let us say something more. Now we using median's property as well as altitude property together, but I can say here this will become altitude. I have drawn altitude, but become median as well as bisector of angle as well as perpendicular bisector of side also. So understand, because symmetric figure, it will become so many things together. So median, altitude, angular bisector and perpendicular bisector of base also. So right now we just using, we draw an altitude but become median. So these two parts also equal. Okay, so obviously they will be a by 2 here. We want to find here altitude. Why? We want to use this formula here. So I can use here Pythagoras formula in any one triangle, both will be equal, both are congruent. Okay, and why it is altitude become medians, you will prove in standard 9 also in geometry lessons. Okay, this is mensuration, but in purely geometry lesson you will prove also why it becomes median. Right now we not go to that part. Okay, so you can see here A square is equal to A by 2 square plus H square. I using Pythagoras formula in this part. So obviously it will become A square is equal to A square by 4 plus H square. Now we want to find H, so just shift it here. So A square by 1 minus H square by 4. You know quarter is subtracted from whole, so obviously 3 by 4 left. Even then you can do your cross multiplication. So 4a square minus 3a square, sorry, 4a square minus 1a square, 3a square. We want h, so root 3a by 2. So that is our altitude in terms of a. So altitude is related to side here this way. So now you can say area is how much? Area is equal to half into base. So base is A here and altitude is root 3 A by 2.
okay, half into base, base is a, altitude we already found in terms of a, so it becomes root 3 by 4 a square. So this formula we derived here, okay. So this derivation again you understand and take screenshot also now. Four equilateral triangle, you can see there. Okay, an application of Pythagoras formula you understood. And what is Pythagoras theorem? Let me clarify once. In a right triangle, square of hypotenuse is equal to, square of hypotenuse equal to sum of squares of other two sides. Square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. Okay, so two side, other two sides are this. And sorry, this one and hypotenuse is A here. So we apply that and found altitude and used here. Now look for isosceles triangle. In isosceles triangle, only two sides occur. Here all three were. Okay, here only two. So let this is the required triangle, these are two equal sides, and let base is B here. Now again, if you draw altitude here, it will become again median also. Median means what? So median is any line segment from vertex to midpoint of opposite side. Median is a line segment in a triangle. In a triangle, not of statistics, from vertex or joining vertex to midpoint of opposite side. So means it bisecting the base also. So means this is midpoint. So I can say here B by 2, B by 2, half B there. And we suppose each of equal sides to be A, each one of equal sides to be A, base is B. According to that usual notation, I have written here formula that are not standard symbol. According to our usual notation only, we written that. So let's see here also. Derivation of formula of area again. So for that purpose, again we have to find H here by applying again Pythagoras formula, because it is right angle triangle. Why right angle triangle? Altitude is drawn, that's why. And median also there, so B by 2 we can write here. So again, hypotenuse square is equal to one side plus other side square sum. So it becomes A square is equal to B square by 4 plus A square. So A square by 1 minus B square by 4 is equal to A square. So obviously 4 and 4 A square minus B square. Now if you want to take square root, means we want H only, so it will be 4 A square minus B square upon 2. Keep in mind it is not perfect square, so don't write 2 A minus B, because if 2 A minus B whole square is there, then only you can say square root 2 A minus B. Not find or not write square root this by individual way. Okay, so can you cannot say 4a square minus b square is equal to 2a minus b. Okay, but you can say 4a square minus, instead of that you can write this way, then only 2a minus b, means whole square should be there, then only you can say. Okay, so this is our altitude. Now let's put this value
in our main formula, A is equal to half into base. Base itself is B here, and it is 4A square minus B square upon 2. 2 is not under root. So it becomes B by 4, 4A square minus B square. But keep in mind one thing, B is base and A is of equal sides. Okay, so this is derivation for isosceles triangle. You can see here. Okay, again, take screenshot with figure. Now let's discuss our main topic, because today our main topic is Heron's formula, and it is applicable whenever all sides are given, no altitude is there. Whatever type is there, that is not important. And even if you know by Pythagorean triplet, if you remember Pythagorean triplet and you know that it is right angle triangle, then also you have to apply Heron's formula only. Keep in mind. Okay. So, what is Heron's formula? I will write here, and when it is applied. So, whenever all sides are given, all three sides are given of any type of triangles. So, let ABC are measure of sides. Okay, then formula will be area of triangle under root S. What is S? We will discuss later on. S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So this is Heron's formula. Okay, where S is semi-perimeter. Okay, and we can write semi-perimeter means what again? Semi means half. So half perimeter. So perimeter by 2. So perimeter means sum of all three sides of triangle divided by 2. Okay, so before applying Heron's formula, you have to find S first of all. So after getting S, ABC mostly given directly or indirectly. Why indirectly? We will talk later on whenever particular sum will come there. But suppose right now you are having ABC, then obviously after finding S, you can use directly this formula and place value. But here square root is there, so at last you have to find square root. For finding square root, you should do mostly factorization, and particularly prime factorization. Okay, so after getting pair, it will be easy to find square root. Okay, so hope you understood. Use and formula with symbol in Heron's formula, whenever it is applied, whenever all sides are given, no altitude is given, and no particular type of triangle is given, nowhere type will be there. Okay, even if after identifying the type, you just apply Heron's formula only. Okay, students, so now let's apply
this formula here by taking one example. So I just giving you very simple example here at our very prior stage. So suppose any triangle with sides 3, 4, 5 centimeter, and we want to find area of triangle. We don't know about that type of triangle. So if measure of sides of triangle are 3 centimeter, 4 centimeter, 5 centimeter, then find its area. So these are ABC. Okay, A small a, small b, small c stands for measurement of sides of a triangle. So let find first of all S. So A plus B plus C by 2 means 3 plus 4 plus 5 by 2 means 3 plus 4 7 plus 5 12 by 2 6. So we got S. Now find out area. Under root S, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. Place all value. We already found S 6. Now see here in sequence only 6 minus 3, 6 minus 4 and 6 minus 5. So it is 6, 6 minus 3, 3, 6 minus 4, 2 and 6 minus 5. Now for getting square root, here it is very simple and small number, but be careful here, don't multiply them, instead factorize them so that you can find square root easily. Here if you multiply all of them, then also you can find square root easily, but not every time. As I told you, it is very simple types of sum, primary types of sum I solve now, okay, but not every time. So don't multiply them, means don't expand them, but factorize. Okay, so even I factorize here 3 into 2 into 3 into 2, no need to write multiply 1. So you can say it is 3 square into 2 square. So now you can write it is 3 into 2, means square root is taken, so square gone. So is equal to 6 centimeter square is our final answer. Explaining again, first of all you given here all three sides and want to find area. So all sides are given, so you have to use Pythagoras formula, sorry, Heron's formula. For getting or applying Heron's formula, first of all find semi-perimeter. So semi-perimeter found. Okay, then write down formula, place all values, simplify it, and at the time of getting square root, just factorize number so that you can have pair of those numbers, so you can get square root easily. Okay, now what type of variation can be here? I just giving you question only in different mode, same question by different mode. Okay, so just understand question only, solution you already understood once. Okay, so I will rub here solution. Now if you want, you can note it down. This is not from textbook, okay, but just for understanding purpose only or application purpose only.
Now my purpose is how same type of question can be given in different mode. So same sentences can be given the measure perimeter of a triangle is 12 centimeter if any two sides are, means measure of two sides are 3 centimeter and 5 centimeter. Find its area, means triangle's area. Same thing is there. First of all, they have given perimeter and two sides given, so you can find the third side. So first of all, you have to do that work. You have to find first of all third side which is not given. Okay, then only after getting third side will be fourth, same work will be there. So that is the one way. Instead of that, suppose you are given sides of triangle are in the ratio 3:4:5. If again perimeter given, perimeter is 12, find area. So instead of giving measure of sides, the relations given 3:4:5. So you know how to find that. You know sum of all sides is given, perimeter, it is given 12 centimeter. So obviously this is not measurement. These are not measurements of sides, they are relations. So you can apply here HCF, means any variable. So let first side be 3x, second side be 4x, third side be 5x. So 3x plus 4x plus 5x is equal to 12y, perimeter is there. So 12x equal to 12, so x equal to 1. After getting x equal to 1, you can say first side is 3 1 3, second is 4 1 4, and third one is 5 1 5. Here coincidentally it is same only measurement and ratios, but not every time. So after getting all three sides, then you can say A equal to 3 multiply 1 3 centimeter. Same way B equal to 4 into 1 4x 4 centimeter. C equal to 5 1 5 centimeter. Now you can do the same way solution of sum. Here you can say, suppose A is given, B is given, suppose C is not given, then how to solve this one? Initial step will be what type of? So that will be like that, all three sides, means A plus B plus C equal to given 12. So let 3 is there, B 5, third side we don't have. So 8 plus C equal to 12, so C equal to 4. So you got third side. Here also you got all side together. Your third side was missing in this one, so that you can. Okay, so this type of different way you can be given question itself. How to solve it, the same thing. Let's see one more example before going to next topic. Suppose they are 13, 14, 15. Sides are 13, 14, 15. This is the first question from your exercise number 14.1. You can open your textbook and look there. And in maths lecture, you should have your textbook as well as notebook and pen also. Okay, and if possible, you can work with teacher also, if you can. Okay, otherwise just concentrate on understanding. So sides are 13, 14, 15, I not writing here question.
only measurements writing 13, 14, 15. So first of all, semi-perimeter equal to 13 plus 14 plus 15 divided by 2. So 3 plus 4, 7 plus 5, 12, 4 divided by 2, 21 centimeter. And the final step should have unit also, whether it is centimeter, meter, whatever may be. Okay. Now area. And you can say ABC anyway, you can say A here, B there, C, okay, that is not important here, because you know multiplication is there and commutative law is followed there. So sequence is not important at all here. So 21, 21 minus 13, 21 minus 14, 21 minus 15. Here it will be 8 7 6. Again, as I told you, don't multiply them, okay, don't make mistake of this type, factorize them. It is 7 into 3, it is 2 into 2 into 2, okay. Prime factorization I writing here, and instead of 6 I return 3 into 2. If two big numbers getting non-prime and you getting pair, then you can write, suppose 8 is anywhere else also, then I will write 8, 8 only, because it making pair, okay. So if any number making pair, then don't factorize it, because you, after all, your purpose is to get pair of same numbers. Okay, now you can see here 7 and 7. So, can I write 7 square? Now 3 is here and 3 is there also. So, 3 square, 2 and 2. So, 2 square, again 2 and 1, 2 means one more pair. And it is not necessary that every time you will have all numbers in pair. Sometimes, suppose 5 is left there, then no problem. You just write root 5 there, okay, instead of getting square root of that. So now I can get here square root 7 into 3 into 2 into 2. So 7 3s are 21, 21 2s are 42, 42 2s are 84. So it is 84 centimeter square. Final answer should have unit also, if it is. Now, in answer, as I told you, some variation may be there in question itself. Okay, you can note it down. And sometimes, maybe answer in final, sorry, maybe variation in some answer step also. How? Suppose you are given, this is a one type of any design, and you want to make paint it. And rate of painting is given, suppose per centimeter it is 2.5 rupees. Then what is the cost of painting this triangular region? So you just multiply after getting area by rate. Rate means cost per unit area. Okay. So again, I just adding here. So this is extra. You are told to find cost of painting this triangle, then what will be cost if rate is given? Suppose it is given 2.5 rupees per centimeter square, then you can say cost equal to, yeah, the cost of painting equal to 84 into 2.5. So 84 into 5 by 2, 4 into, 42. So 42 into 5, it will be 210 rupees. That will be your answer. Okay, so after getting area, you can go ahead according to what is asked. Okay, so according to requirement, you can find it last. But getting area is important here, and that is our main part. Note it down or take screenshot of that part. Now one question may arise in your mind. Suppose they have specified types of triangle also. Then whether to use Heron's formula or use that formula. So if they have specified, you can use this formula, but you not to prove and then use. Okay, so it is not expected to prove first of all types of triangle and then use that formulas. Understood? But if it is specified already, then you can use. Okay, so I hope you understood my point and no confusion will be there. Now look at second question of that exercise. Now we're taking questions from textbook. And we are in exercise 14.1. In second one, they have given two sides 8 and 11 centimeter. Perimeter is given 32. So you have to find again area. So I already told you in this type of sum what to do. Obviously, to find first of all missing side. One side is missing. Okay, so that you have to find first of all. So perimeter is given, and in mathematics sum it is mostly expected to list out first of all everything what is given. So let's make first of all list here. They have given perimeter, so it is 32 centimeter. They have given two sides also, let they are A and B. And write whatever not given that also. So means everything is clear here. And after all, what is asked there? That also you can write in symbolic way, area is asked. But you know, before finding area, you have to find missing side first of all. How? Very simple. So perimeter means, if you can, you can write this type of, first of all, step also in formula way. 8 is given, 11 is given, third side is not given. So 19 plus C equal to 32. So C will be 13. So third side you got here. Again, last step of any stage. In a whole solution, it may be multi-stage solution. So in each stage, last step, whatever you got, should be with unit. Okay. Now you can see your S directly, 32 by 2, 16. No need to sum again and then to do, because perimeter itself is there. Now area, and every time it is compulsory to write formula, not to write directly values.
16, 16 minus 8, 16 minus 11, and 16 minus 30. Okay, side 8, 11 and third side is 13, they all are subtracted, means values are placed and difference taken here. Now here 8 is there, so your purpose is to get 8 here, not go to prime level, not necessary here. Because we got it. Now what is need to write here 2, 2, 2 and here also 2 into 2 into 2? Okay, it is meaningless. So it is now 8 square into 2 into 5 into 3. Not making pair these numbers. So just they will retain under root only. So it will be 8 into 2, 5 are 10, 3 are 30. 30 is not perfect square number, you know. Centimeter square or square centimeter. That is our final answer. Okay, so only initial step means starting portion is new. Otherwise, same process is here. And most of students feel difficulty or make mistake at the time of getting square root here. So be careful, and if you are not getting it anyway, then do prime factorization. That is the last way. After getting prime factorization, well, you must have square root. Is question number 2 from exercise 14.1. Now you can read question number 3. It is same type of. So that is in homework. Exercise 14.1, question number 3. This is our first sum in homework. Okay, now look at number 4. Area of equilateral triangle is given. So obviously they specified here it is equilateral triangle, and you know formula of area of equilateral triangle. It is given 16 root 3. Find side and perimeter. Obviously area is given, so we have to find side first of all, and then perimeter very easily we will have. So what is given again? A. 16 root 3 centimeter square. What is asked? Side means we using here A, and perimeter P. So what is given, what is asked, everything clear here? Now you know area of triangles formula. Is here side of triangle. So it is given 16 root 3. Root 3 by 4 a square.
just shift them here, 16 root 3 into 4 upon root 3 equal to a square. Root 3 cancel out, 64 is equal to a square. It is simple number, small number, so I multiply. Otherwise again I have to factorize here also. So it is 8. So first answer you got, but it is symbolic answer. So you should write statement also at last. Keep in mind. If it is not standard unit, mostly they are not standard unit, then you have to give your final answer in statement compulsory, because it is symbols supposed by us. Some student may suppose L also there, some may be other also. Okay, so examiner cannot assume to understand what is A. Okay, so it is not supposed to give answer in this way. So at last, otherwise at this stage you can say that side of the triangle is 8 cm with unit. Now perimeter, you know perimeter means what? 3 times side, otherwise 8 plus 8 plus 8, otherwise 8 threes are 24 cm. Is very simple. But suppose you are not expecting to use this formula, but using Heron's formula only you want to find or want to solve this sum, then how to do? Let's see that way also. Okay, so suppose you don't know this formula here, then how to get answer by Heron's formula? So let's see. Here all sides are A. All sides are A. So what will be P first of all? Oh sorry, S first of all. It will be A plus A plus A. A means any side, we want that. Divide by 2 means 3A by 2. Area itself given. So now write A is equal to S, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. Write down whatever given here. This one is 3A by 2. Now 3A by 2 minus A. Again, 3A by 2 minus A, because all sides are equal. So no different symbols. Nothing to do here, just copy it. Now what is the subtraction here? So 3A by 2, obviously 3 by 2 minus 1, half. So it will be A by 2, A by 2, A by 2. They just cross multiply, you can know. How much it is? 3, A 4, A into A into A raised to 4, 2 to the 4 to the 8 to the 16. So that formula will come here, 16 root 3 is equal to root 3 A square by 4. So that is a one type of derivation from Heron's formula. Look there, that only came here. Okay, now same way you can find missing side, means A here. So side of equilateral triangle. Understood? So we derive this formula by finding altitude. Now that is the second derivation of this formula. It is derived from Heron's formula. Okay, same way you can derive this isosceles triangle's formula also by Heron's one. Okay, we already solved here by altitude, finding altitude by using Pythagoras theorem. But instead that, you can use Heron's formula here with same symbol. So at last step you will have that formula. Okay, students, so now I hope you getting my point. And particularly today we discuss mostly Heron's formula and its application. Now one more sum I want to give you in homework, and that is number 10. Question number 10. There are three sides given. Sorry, not 10 but number 7. 120, 160 and 200 means all three sides are given. Find the cost of plowing at 25 paisa per square meter. I already told you, instead of area, they want cost of tilling, cost of painting, cost of whitewashing, cost of fitting tiles. All this type of work related to area. Obviously, the plowing means what here? Tilling. So area is related. So after getting area, just multiply by 0.25, means 1 by 4. Okay, so only one step will be new, but I giving you hint. At last, after getting area, you just multiply for getting cost by 0.25. So you will have final answer in rupees. So writing here number of that question also. So at initial stage, I giving you only two sums and hope you will do it successfully. And if any problem is there, you just go through, solve some first of all. And after understanding or even after trying them to solve in exam condition, you try to solve them. But obviously, you will solve them successfully because you practice well here. Okay, students. So now remaining sums we will solve later on, but keep in mind again it is mensuration related to area of triangle, but maybe their quadrilateral also, and somewhat basic will also be useful there. Okay, so any types of basic concept of geometry can be used at any step. Okay, so let's end our today's lecture here and hope you understood everything and you will solve both given sums with so enthusiasm and so interest. Okay, students, thank you very much. Meet you again.